And how's everybody on this great Friday morning? It's a little bit dark in here. We're still having electrical problems. The electrician's coming next week, so we'll get everything then. But let's have a word of prayer, and we're going to get started. Father, thank you so much for today. Thank you for all you've done for us. I just pray now that you'll guide and direct everything that's said and done here today to be for your honor and glory. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Well, we're setting up for food bank. I'm a little bit late getting in here. But today we're going to be looking at a person by the name of Elizabeth. Elizabeth. And Elizabeth was Zechariah's wife. That's John the Baptist's mother. And now there's not a whole lot in the Bible talked about her except in Luke chapter 1. And we're going to be looking at that a little bit to see what she is and who she was. And I think we can see a little bit from her character of how God can use just about anybody for his honor and glory. But the name Elizabeth comes from the meaning of God is my oath. You know, we know not much about Elizabeth's life prior to the angel Gabriel coming and announcing that they were going to have a baby. Now, we need to understand that Elizabeth was very old. She was probably in her 60s or 70s when angel Gabriel came to her and said she was going to have a child. She was childless. She had never had a baby before. And we need to understand that, this is going to be a complete miracle for her to have a child. Now, she was a daughter of Aaron's relatives. What that means is that she was related to Aaron, and she was a cousin to Mary, the mother of Jesus. In Luke chapter 1, verse 5, it says, there was in the days of Herod, the king of Judah, a certain priest named Zacharias, and of course of Abra, and his wife was a daughter of Aaron, and her name was Elizabeth. In Luke chapter 1 and verse 36, it says, and behold, thy cousin Elizabeth, she hath also conceived a son in her old age, and this is her sixth month with her who was called barren. Now, it's uncertain how Mary and Elizabeth were cousins. However, this is very important that we realize that they were related. They were of the same sex, so to speak. They were of the same genealogy. Now, the Lord, though not of the priestly tribe, was related to it. He fulfilled it in his distinct priesthood of Melchizedek's order. And in order for Jesus to be the high priest, he had to be somehow related closely to the line of Aaron. Now, there's a lot in this, in that Jesus had to be of the priestly line of Aaron. Aaron, as we know, was the first high priest. He was the first high priest that God had put in the office. And any priest from there on had to be a relative of Aaron or of the line of Aaron. And so here we see that Elizabeth was of the line of Aaron. Actually, Zechariah, her husband, was. And like her husband, Elizabeth was a righteous before God, walking in all the commandments and ordinances of the Lord. She was blameless. You know, what a beautiful marriage relationship between Elizabeth and her husband. You know, as I was writing this, I could only think of marriages today. You know, if we had marriages today where both the husband and wife were righteous and walked in all their ways with God, we'd have a lot fewer families breaking up and everyone going their own way. Now, I can see Elizabeth and her husband going to church together and worshiping as a family. I can see the two of them having daily devotions together and praying together as a family. You know, even though they had no children, they lived their lives the way the Lord had ordained them to live them. You know, what a better inscription what better of a example could a husband and wife be to others that are around them in the way they live their lives for the Lord, in the way they go to church, in the way they do everything together for the honor and glory of God. You know, she was the first to bless Mary as the mother of the Lord. In Luke chapter 1, verses 40 to 45, it says this: "And entered into the house of Zacharias and saluted Elizabeth. And it came to pass that when Elizabeth heard the salutation of Mary, the babe leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Ghost. And she spake out with a loud voice, saying, Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb. And whence is this to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For lo, as soon as thy voice, thy salutation, sounded mine ear, the babe leaped in my womb for joy. And blessed is she that believed. For there shall be a performance of those things which were told her from the Lord." You know, I've always wondered why Mary went to her cousin, who lived quite a ways away from them, to see her first. She was the first one that Mary wanted to go and give the news to that she was expecting. Now, I can see why she went after reading this and after seeing how God used her to bring in the good news that Jesus was going to be born. Joseph wanted to put Mary away privately so that no one knew she was expecting. After all, a woman who was not married in those days was considered a very bad person. If you were with child and you weren't married, it was thought that either you had an adulterous affair with your husband-to-be or with someone else. Now, Joseph had never been with Mary because she had conceived her child off of the Holy Spirit. You know, he wanted to take and put her away privately. He did not want to have to answer the questions as to why she was with child and they weren't married. You know, this is something that Joseph did not want to have to take and deal with. You know, Mary knew her cousin was a godly older woman who had a lot of knowledge about life and about spiritual things. You know, if she was going to learn how to raise a godly family, she needed to go and see a godly woman. You know, if only we had young girls today like Mary was, who would seek out godly older women in the church and learn how they raised their family, I believe that we would have more godly families around in our society. You know, and how we need to groom our young ladies for the honor and glory of God. You know, there's an awful lot of young ladies, young teenagers going to and fro today that are not doing what they should for the honor and glory of God. They're not in church like they should be. They go wherever they want. They go with whatever boy they want. They do things that are not godly. And what we need is godly teenagers who will live their lives for the honor and glory of God. You know, it's unknown. It is unknown anything about Mary's mother. However, we do know that she went to a person who could help her through the start of her life in motherhood and also being a newly wed wife. Now, we need to understand that Mary went to her cousin Elizabeth because she wanted good godly advice from someone. And if you young ladies, or if you're listening today, can find an older lady who can take and give you good godly advice, you need to go and listen to them. You need to take and talk to them and have them show you what they have done in their life. If we do that, I guarantee that you're going to have a great life. You're going to have a good married life. You're going to be a good mother. And after all, Mary was a good mother. Mary raised Jesus greatly. And so did Elizabeth. Elizabeth raised John the Baptist in the way that God wanted him to be raised. And as we know the story, Herod later on took the head of John the Baptist. However, we need to understand that he was there for a reason, and that was to usher in the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. You know, Elizabeth, there was not much written about her, but she had a very important part in the birth of the Lord. And we need to understand that. We need to realize that in all things, everything works together for good to those who love God and are called according to his purpose. Let's have a word of prayer. Father, thank you so much for this story of Elizabeth. We know, Lord, that you can use anybody for your honor and your glory. We thank you for today. We pray for the food bank today. We pray that we'll get everything passed out that we need to get done. And Father, we just love you so much. We thank you for what you've done for us. I just pray now that you'll continue to guide and direct us in all that we do and say. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right. Thank you for tuning in today. Don't forget, Sunday morning, Sunday school at 9 o'clock, Sunday morning church at 10 o'clock. You don't want to miss Sunday school, because this coming Sunday, I got a special guest going to be here, and you want to be here to see him. So be here Sunday morning, 9 o'clock, and we will see you all Monday morning, same time, same place. God bless. Have a great weekend. Thanks, Dana.